Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the Lab-RAT-ory with another segment of what airbrush is right for you. We continue with Iwata, and it's my pleasure to introduce you to possibly the one airbrush that stands above all the others in terms of being a racehorse, a workhorse, a thoroughbred, whatever you want to call it. Of course, I'm talking about the Iwata Eclipse HPCS, which also comes in another form, which is the smaller cup, the Iwata Eclipse BS. Okay, same airbrush, same beautiful inner works and design and all of that. Except it's got a smaller cup, which I basically use for putting little drops of paint, doing some detail work. Now, this airbrush, by the way, this comes with certain kits. This is a moisture trap at the trigger, so to speak, and it comes with some kits. And when you buy them, it's not very good. I have about 7 of these. They tend to break. They tend to break right here, especially if you are using it with 45 PSI and above. So just a little warning, they tend to break. It's not a big deal. You should have a moisture trap at the other end of the hose anyway, at the air compressor. This is the one that I use most of the time. Now, this airbrush, the Eclipse HPCS, double action, and of course you can tell that the sun's coming up because I've got the shadow. Woo! I like that. Look, it's a bunny now. No, it's a rabbit. Oh, but I digress. Anyway, this is the airbrush that I use for all sorts of jobs. You can do base coats with this one. You could do detail work. I mean, it comes in with a very fine line, very fine spray. This is the airbrush with which you could do all sorts of tricks, like stippling, which is, you know, you drop the air pressure and then you stipple. A great technique for when you're doing rat rods and other weathered junkers and daily drivers and beaters and you name it. It's a good all-around airbrush, and we use them for all sorts of things here in the laboratory. So I can't sing its praises enough. The double action, which since it's the first time we're talking about this, it basically means that you have to get used to this, which is, you know, you come in with your finger, okay? And you press down, which releases the air, okay? And this is a good trick for drying your paints quickly. Then as you pull back on the trigger, like that, pulling back, like that, it releases the paint flow. The further back, the more paint, okay? So it's double action, it takes some getting used to. You can find good deals on this airbrush, and I'm going to post a link to Tube KGB. He's got a 30% deal going on all Iwata products. Now, I don't want to give you the impression that you can't do with another airbrush with this what you can with this. That wouldn't be true. You could do it. But this gun feels very good. It's completely reliable, very easy to maintain, take apart, maintain. It can withstand urethanes and lacquers, no problem. And, one of the things that I do often is I remove the crown, okay? And this way it allows you to come even closer. And you want to expose the tip of your needle. You also have to be very careful because you can pinprick yourself, you can bend it. You can do all kinds of horrible things. to it. So my recommendation is, you know, learn to use it with a cap on, but I use it without the cap because more often than not, when I'm using metallizers and white and all that, I like to keep the tip completely clean. So I'll do maybe 3, 4, 5 strokes and then clean the tip. This way you don't have paint building up and drying there. So just an all-around fabulous brush. And as I said, very well designed, very well built, and very easy to maintain, take apart. With this one, I use an eyedropper, as I said, and I put little drops of paint. And this one will also do detail work, and it'll get you closer. It's wearing a different kind of crown on top, which has these slots. But it's the same thing. I take it off when I do detail work. Not a big deal. Here's the thing. We've been having that conversation, you know, which airbrush. It's all a personal matter. My recommendation, time and again, is for the prospective airbrusher, new, medium skill or advanced. If you're thinking of getting a new airbrush, go to the source. Go somewhere in town where you can hold it in your hand, look at it. Some places will let you unbox it and look at it. You know, look at the instructions. Get yourself really familiarized. Now, in the case of my first Eclipse, I have to confess, I slept with that sucker. You know, I lived with it for weeks. I took it to work. I took it with me on trips. I just loved the thing for the way it looked and felt, and also because I wanted to get a good grasp of it. So you see the finger there. I mean, it's just smooth sailing, you know. Most kits will come with a lubricant for the needle. It's kind of a conditioner. It's good to use. It keeps the gun at the ready at all times. And so, you know, when it's cleaning time, I soak these in cheap lacquer thinner if I'm using enamels and up. And then Windex windshield cleaning fluid when I am using acrylics, and it'll see you through a lot of years of fun painting. And as I said, if you take care of your airbrush, regardless what brand it is, it'll see you through your time in the hobby. So you know, as I said, give it a go, look at it, you know, shop around for good deals, and basically, you know, find out which one's going to work best for you, right? And that's what it is. And my theory is that once you learn to use one airbrush, you can transfer those skills to the next. So don't think, oh, you know, I learned to use the Pache or the Badger, I can't use anything else, or vice versa. If you get to use this, which I did for a long time, then I started using the Pache H single action. It took a little bit getting used to, but you do it. You do it time and again. So anyway, let me know what you think. Shop around, save your money. It's an expensive airbrush coming in at anywhere between $117 and $147. So it's not cheap, but I can guarantee you that once you use it, you're going to have a hard time using anything else. And also, rattle cans are going to be a thing of the past. Not necessarily. You know, you'll continue to use it for all sorts of things. But, you know, once you start spraying with the airbrush, you will see the beauty of it. And again, no fear. Don't be fearful of it. As I said, get used to it quickly, and you'll see. Everybody, if I was able to do it, you can too. You're talking to a math impaired, electricity impaired, number impaired, technical impaired person who's hands-on. That's the one thing, you know. I love these things, and I just love to learn to use them. So check it out, and shop around. Compare prices. As I said, don't give up. If you have somebody local and you find a better deal online, then, you know, talk to them. Give them a chance. You know, shop locally and see if they're willing to give you the same price break. Sometimes they can't, but in which case, then, you know, get your best deal online. But keep the local economy going, folks. All right, my friends, stay tuned in for more airbrush discussion. Have a good one.